What's the issue, dear? Why are you holding back from such a man? Is it the clumpy way he walks?
Or the grumpy way he talks?
Or the pear-shaped, square-shaped weirdness of his feet?
And though we know he washes well, he always ends up sorta smelly.
But you'll never meet a fella who's as sensitive and sweet.
So he's a bit of a fixer-upper, so he's got a few flaws. But his peculiar brain, dear,
his thing with the reindeer, that's a little outside of nature's laws.
So he's a bit of a fixer-upper, but this we're certain of.
He runs scared.
Or that he's socially impaired.
Or that he only likes to tinkle in the wind.
What?
Are you holding back your fondness due to his unmanly blondness?
Or the way he covers up that he's the honest goods.
He's just a bit of a fixer-upper. He's got a couple of bloods.
His isolation
is confirmation of his desperation for healing up.
He's a bit of a fixer-upper, but we know what to do.
The
way to fix up this fixer-upper is to fix him up for you.
Enough! She's engaged to someone else, okay?
So she's a bit of a fixer-upper, that's a minor thing.
Her quote engagement is a flex arrangement.
And by the way, I don't see no ring.
So she's a bit of a fixer-upper, her brain's a bit betwixt.
Get the fiancé out of the way and the whole thing will be fixed.
We're not saying you can change him, cause people don't really change.
We're only saying that love's a force that's powerful and strange. People make bad choices if their man's scared or stressed.
That can fix a fixer-upper is
true.